Hi guys. Larissa Glitter Sparkle here. How y'all doing? How's everything going? Everything good? Everything's good over here. You like my background I got going on? It's left over from my friend's bachelorette party that I threw yesterday. So what I'm going to be talking about today is I'm finally doing part two to my hair dyeing my hair. Yeah, dyeing my hair video. I had been wanting to do box braids for literally years. 4 years. And the only reason that I had never done it is because I was just, well, first of all, I was nervous that it wouldn't fucking look good. That shit takes forever to put in, so I didn't want to like waste my time and money doing a style that wasn't gonna look good. I finally just got the courage, and I got recommended by a girl that I went to high school with. One of her friends did hair. So I don't know this girl's name. I only met her once. She only ever did my hair once. And then I moved on to a different stylist. But anywho, I went to Sam's Beauty Supply. That's where I went. Not that any of you may know where that is. I knew I wanted to do box braids, but I didn't want to do real box braids. So I wanted to do crochet, which is basically a method where you braid, you get cornrows, you braid your hair back, and they take a latch hook, and you can get hair that's pre-looped, so it has a little loop at the end or at the top, or you can get non-looped hair, whatever. I wanted green, and I bought pre-looped faux box braids. So what this girl did, which I should have known my ass was in trouble when she was lighting up before she did my hair, like smoking weed. And you know what? To each their own. But goddamn, she was braiding so slow. It took us 9 hours and 8 packs of hair. I mean, it looked cute, but that shit was heavy. And now, mind you, that was the first time I'd ever had any style like that. I knew, yeah, probably gonna hurt. Yeah, it's probably gonna be heavy. Oh, I was not prepared. By the time that she got done, I was so tired of sitting there. Because first of all, I expected maybe 6 hours. It was almost 10 hours by the time that we were done. Most people don't take that long to do it. Depending on how big your head is and how much hair you got and the size of braid that you want. But son of a biscuit eater, that was rough. That was a rough introduction to braids and box braids and all sorts of stuff. I did like it. I loved it. I loved the look. I loved that I could wake up and my hair was done. I was good. So, disclaimers. If you get these little bumps around your hair follicle, those are called tension bumps. And that means your shit's too tight. Now, yes, it will loosen up after a couple of days. But if you are tender-headed, if you have a lot of hair, I would not recommend adding in hair to do box braids. You might be able to do it with your own hair. And make sure you tell them to not braid tight, especially depending on your hair type. So just for the know, I did not know. Ooh. I'm drinking the leftover liquor from the bachelorette party, and it's pretty good. Where the hell was I? And I liked it, but I knew I could do better. I knew I could probably find somebody that wouldn't blaze up before they did my hair and spend 10 hours braiding my hair. Because, I mean, who the fuck has the time? Like, seriously. I mean, well, everybody has time now. But that's not the point. Nobody ain't got no money. I took out those braids. most of them I didn't have to cut out, so I was able to save a lot of them. I mean, I had 8 packs of hair, and I ended up saving probably six and a half. And I ended up finding someone else that does braids. All of her information will be in the inbox, or in the inbox, will be in the description. Will be in the description box below. Her name is Not or Noni, and her Instagram is Nokari. And she is the lady that I have gone to since to get my hair done. I saved a lot of those pre-lubed box braids, and I actually met Noni, or Noni. I always say her damn name wrong. Noni. I met her through a girl that I actually worked with. She was just so kind, so sweet, cute, funny, and willing to work with my hair type. So that was perfect. I loved that. We got together. I told her kind of what I was wanting to do. I showed her the hair that I had, and we just went from there. And that is this picture. So cute. I mean, they looked cute before, but the first time I had gotten it done, we used way too much fucking hair, and it was all like clustered at the back of my head, so it felt like I had a fucking pillow. It was not comfortable. The second round, doing it with Noni, perfect. Like, we didn't even use all of the hair. She did also do a crochet method with that. Oh God, that was so long ago. No, we didn't do a crochet method with that one. What we did was we did a rubber band method, and then we crocheted my, or we crocheted, fed, feed in, I don't know, crocheted my hair into actual each braid. So that's how we did it that time. And it, oh my God, it was so amazing. I loved it so much. Now, when you have styles like that, you're not gonna be able to wash your hair like every day, like at all. Because if you do, you're gonna frizz up your roots, you're gonna be looking crazy, and it just basically makes your hair look frizzy and nappy, and we don't want that. So if you are someone that washes their hair every day, don't get braids or any type of weaves or extensions that you can't wash every day, because it is gonna drive you nuts. You can use dry shampoo, but that shit'll build up, clog your pores, and nobody wants that either. So me, I already don't wash my hair every day. I have curly hair, and if I tried to wash it every day, it would fucking fall out. So I'm used to not washing my hair. Sometimes I won't wash my hair for like 2 weeks. No big deal. It's fine. I do like a co-wash in the shower, so I'll like shower, use conditioner, comb it out, and that's about it. But so with these styles, what I do is, as long as you're not putting a lot of product in the styled hair, you're not going to get buildup on your scalp. You could do a light wash, which, so if I know I'm going to keep this style in for 3 to 4 weeks, then midway through I'll do a wash, like a thorough wash, and just be really gentle. Now, mind you, though, when you get, depending on the style that you do, like when I had the faux box braids, that shit gets heavy as fuck when it's wet, and it takes forever to dry. So I try to just mainly get my scalp wet, and then, or you can, in a spray bottle, I would put water with a little bit of soap, shake it up, and just kind of spray it around and just massage my scalp, and then spray with just water to kind of rinse it out a little bit, so that way I'm not getting all of the braids and everything wet. It's work. If I did a wash day, it would take me a day. So I would usually wash it on like a Saturday. But I mean, compared to, that's one day that you have to really deal with your hair for weeks. I mean, now, also too, if you're gonna wear protective styles like that, also, you should oil your scalp or some type of moisturizer. And before you put your hair in any type of style like that, you need to condition your hair or put some type of oil so that way your hair isn't getting dry and then breaking while it's in braids. That's also important. When we did that style, it took, I think, about 5-6 hours, which was way fucking better than almost 10. So that was doable. It could be done like on a Saturday, Sunday, whenever you got time. And she was always accommodating to me. So I would actually pay her a little bit extra to have her come to my house. It worked out nice. After that style, I made a boo-boo. When I went to take that hair down, when you have your hair up like that, especially if you, well, no matter how you have it, when you take your extensions out or your weave or whatever, you want to make sure you thoroughly comb that section of hair and then put it aside and then do that all around your head. I didn't do that. I got lazy. I decided to take my hair down late in the evening. I got tired because it was taking longer than I anticipated, and I just wanted to be done with it. And I rushed the process, didn't comb out the sections the way I should have, and ended up with essentially a dreadlock at the nape of my neck. So I had to chop my hair off. I had called my hairdresser, told her the situation. She was like, "Well, you're a dumbass." And I was like, "Yeah, I know." So I had to cut my hair. She really tried to, I tried conditioner, she tried conditioner, detangler. I mean, we tried literally everything we could to untangle the hair, but it was no use. So, and most of it was all fried from all the dyeing and all that shit I had been doing previous. So we cut it, and I had short hair. Thank God. Thank God it looked good, because otherwise, oh my God, it would, no. Okay, so the next one we did was my black and blue faux locks. I wanted to do a similar method to how we had done the previous box braids, where she would feed in my hair through the box braid or through the faux lock, but they were too small. So she ended up doing another crochet. And I've found for my hair, crochet is honestly the best method, unless I'm doing straight like box braids, because my hair doesn't necessarily have that kinky enough texture to really hold on to stuff. So I just have to have a little more security in attaching hair to my head that's, you know, not mine. Well, you know what? Actually, if I bought it now, yeah, it's mine. It just didn't grow out of my head. So I did the black and blue faux locks. I usually do at least 18 inches. Sleeping is not the easiest. You really have to take care of your locks. What I normally do is I would either, if I couldn't find my silk bonnet, I would just use a t-shirt and just basically make a bun of some type and then just knot it. And to, you know, just keep your hair from getting, first of all, for you, you know, from strangling yourself. And then also just keeping it nice and pretty and not letting it get frizzy and dirty. And that style, the faux locks that she did, that only took about 5 hours, because she did a different braid pattern. Plus also my hair was shorter, so we had less hair to deal with. And, she just did, a crochet with using a latch hook and just connected, and those were, I do believe those were pre-looped as well. They do get heavy, but I mean, it's nothing, at least to me, it's nothing that's not manageable. And obviously the more you do styles like that, your scalp gets used to the tension, gets used to the weight, and it doesn't hurt as much the more you do it. The pain that I feel now compared to the very first time I got them done, nothing. Like, I mean, it's slightly uncomfortable, like you just, you know, getting used to it. But other than that, it ain't bad. It's worth it, in my opinion. If you got the money to spend. And I haven't had my hair done recently because I don't have the money to spend. The next one that we did was purple and white. And this time we did actual box braids. So she sectioned off a part of my hair and then fed in extension hair and braided it all the way down. And I think those were about 18 inches as well. And that one took about 8 hours. Maybe not quite 8 hours, but just about. And those felt very different than doing a crochet because when you do a crochet, your hair is actually to your head and the extension comes off of that. So when the extension moves, oh, I don't know, something crazy outside. So when the hair actually moves, you don't really feel it. When you do rail box braids, that's your fucking hair. So every time you move, your whole scalp is moving. So that was definitely different. But I actually liked it better because it, first of all, we didn't use as much hair. My scalp got air to it, so I wasn't as hot. And it just, honestly, like when I would shake my head, I would feel all of it move and it just. Ugh, felt so good. And then also too, like after a couple of days, once your hair is kind of loosened up and you go to touch your scalp.
Bitch. Oh my God, that is far amazing.
Oh, whoa. Because it gives me chills thinking about it because I'm like, oh my God, that felt so fucking good. Now, the only style that I've done with Noni that pretty much everybody loved and like I got literally the most compliments on. I did four cornrows back into low ponytails and then had loose red curly hair. Bitch, that was like my favorite. I'm definitely gonna do that again. The maintenance on that was super fucking easy. I just honestly, with that one, I did not wash my hair. I had it for 4 weeks. I didn't wash it. I did do a light dry shampoo, and I had washed my hair a day before I got the braids and deep conditioned the night before. So, and that one was the most easy to take down because she literally just added hair as she braided back. I mean, it was super easy. And that one only took 2 hours, and I fucking liked that. That was A-okay in my book. It was the least amount of time to put in, the easiest to take care of, and it looked really cute on me, I think. And my dad actually even liked that one, which really surprised me because he does not like when I do any type of braids, wigs, extensions, anything that's not natural. He's like, and that was the only one that he was like, oh my God, Mija, you look so pretty. And I was like, oh, thank you. Oh my God. All of these styles, except for like the very first one, I've liked all of them. I felt like they looked good on me. They were relatively easy to take care of, and it was something that I'd probably do again. The only one that I really did not like and didn't turn out the way that I was hoping, was the short blue and black chunky locks that I did, and I did faux locks using a wrapping method. And I was going for like a short bob just to try something new. I think I kept that in for a week, and I didn't like how it looked on me. And it had no nothing to do with Noni's technique or how she put them in. Like, she did a really good job. They were wrapped nicely, they weren't too stiff. I just think that specific style, we did kind of big ones, and I think that was a mistake on my part. We should have done smaller ones with different hair, and I think her and I have been kind of talking, and I think we're gonna try that style again. Well, I want to try that style again, and we're gonna do, instead of braiding hair or any type of synthetic hair, I think we're actually gonna do wool dreads. So we kind of have that one in the works once this whole, quarantine, social distancing shit is over. And the short locks, that took, oh, that one took 7 hours. And I felt so bad. Like I she kept asking me how the style was going. I was like, I took it out after a week. And she was like, oh my God, did I not do something right? And I was like, no. You did everything perfect. I'm just a brat and I didn't like it. So, and like, unfortunately, when you're doing styles like that, you kind of have to finish the whole style to know how it's gonna look. And I wasn't gonna, after she did all that work, turn around and be like, I don't like it, take it out. No, I just took it out myself. I gave it a week. Any style you do, give it at least 7 days because you gotta have time for it to settle in. Then you gotta have time to be able to style it. And that takes time. So I gave it 7 days. I still wasn't happy with it. And I took it out. So that was on me. But I know now that that look does not work for me. So, and that was the last style that we did. Like I said, we have been kind of chit-chatting about doing some different kind of locks, using wool dreads, or yeah, wool dreads. And that's kind of where we left off. And then, all this shit happened, so that was my that was my weave story. So I hope you enjoyed it. And have fun. Be safe. Don't cough on nobody. And I'll see y'all later in the next video. So, bye guys.